The graduation of a new batch of the academy. I'd like to congratulate the whole nation, the new cadets, for distinguished performance. Would you please, sir, give us more details about the training and qualifying programs of the cadets? The Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces and the General Commander of the Armed Forces always stress that the cadets are our responsibility. Since they joined the military academy, we do evaluate this word. Since the very first day for the cadets in the military academy, we build their character to be based on our military tradition, sense of belonging to the country, the correct awareness against any danger targeting their minds or threatening the country. Sir, your message to the new cadets and their families. I'd like to congratulate all the cadets and their families who officially today joined the armed forces. Of course, I wish for them the best of luck and advise them to adopt loyalty, sincerity. Those are the key words of success. Today, you are the officers of today and the commanders of the future. A new batch to be graduated today to join our armed forces. Another addition to the armed forces with the unprecedented leaps it's witnessing, whether in weaponry, training, or combating capabilities in accordance with the latest techniques in the frame of the self-development process taking place within the armed forces. Now we are joined by the Naval College Director, Rear Admiral Mahmoud Fawzi, to shed more light on how a cadet of the Naval Academy is qualified. Congratulations, sir. Tell us more about the programs of training and qualification, the qualifications to guarantee that the cadet is coping with the latest techniques in this field. We work with the cadet on three pillars: scientific, psychological, disciplinary. It's according to an intensive program since the first day of the student in the academy. At the first period of the preparation is the base or the turning point, transferring the cadet from the civil way of life to the military one. The student joined the Naval College, whether for 4 academic years if he is a secondary school graduate, or 2 years if he is a university graduate. The students study general military sciences, specialized maritime sciences, basic engineering, basics of physics, chemistry, in addition to language. And upon the directives of the general commander of the armed forces, the students specialize in the last year, which is the fourth year, in one of the following main branches: maritime studies, missiles, underwater missiles, signal department. We also depend on training camps, whether inside or outside Egypt. In these camps, we use the newest units of our Navy. The cadet gets acquainted with the theater of naval operations, whether within the North Fleet of the Mediterranean or the Southern Fleet of the Red Sea. Also, to know about the economic targets of the state, the naval bases, Suez Gulf, Suez Canal, the Gulf. The Gulf of Aqaba. We are also sent our cadets to the external camps, which are included into the joint military drills and the plan of the general command in joint drills. The student or the cadet go through long hours of sailing, also visits naval colleges of brotherly and friendly nations. We are still celebrating the graduation ceremony of the new batches, the new blood injected into our armed forces. We are now delighted to have with us the director of the Air Force Academy, Staff Major General Ali Hassan Ali. A new batch with questions regarding the training and qualification of the cadets until he reached the maximum readiness and to be graduated. The Air Force Academy cadet obtains the highest levels of training There are pillars on which we depend: military, psychological skills and knowledge. We start with the military aspect since day one here in the military academy, and it would continue with the cadets till their graduation. The psychological aspect is how we form the character, and to prepare the cadet, we do focus on the character of the cadet, how to make him enjoying fast reaction, taking the correct and right decisions. And here we are all the time helped by specialists via lectures and programs. Via the educational process, science and knowledge, it's a vital part all over the years of studies upon the directives of the political leadership and the command of our college. We have the latest curricula, digital curricula, or the CPT or Zero Client. The cadet has e-books with interactive programs. And these interactive programs enable the cadet to interact with what he studies, audio, video. And we continue with developing ourselves. Despite being awarded with ISO, we are not satisfied with that. Now we upgrade our servers, we cooperate with the signal department to increase the speed, to connect all our sections together to achieve effectiveness, and to reach the learning managing system, or the LMS, to realize the And now we are very much delighted to have with us the Staff Major General Abdulaziz Omar, the manager of this is the batch number 45. We'd like to know more about the training programs and the qualifications of the cadets. Of course, we do have a joint protocol with the Faculty of Engineering, Alex University. Our cadets now obtain the bachelor degree. Also, the Common Command of the Armed Forces and the Air Defense Academy are providing us and providing the cadets with the most modern labs and educational systems. Also, I'd like to listen to you. What do you say to the cadets and their families in their graduation day with the presence of the Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces, President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi? We are all pleased with the presence of the Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces, but this is a huge responsibility. Despite all his tough responsibilities, he is very keen to join us, and we should be up to the mission to follow up the latest techniques. It's a very heavy mission to protect the skies of Egypt, and I'd like to say to all our sons to follow the steps of the older generation. This is coinciding with celebrating the victories of October War. This college was established in 1974, right after the victories of October War. We should continue with learning and learning. Also, they should take care of their soldiers. The soldiers are the best on earth. He should convey all the messages he had through the 4 years to his soldiers. And we are with Professor Dr. Ismail Kamal, the director of the Technical Military College. Congratulations to all the cadets. Would you please tell us, sir, about the qualifications and the training of the cadets during the years of studying in the college? After graduation, they are going to shoulder this responsibility during the years of studies for 5 years. The cadets are qualified scientifically, military, and disciplinary to be able to deal with all the technologies, all the latest modern weaponries, and after 5 years, they are graduated with a bachelor degree in engineering. They are completely ready, fully ready to deal with all the modern weaponry systems. What do you like to say to your sons? This is really a turning point. This is a very special day with the Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces attending the graduation ceremony. What is the message you want to convey to your sons? I do congratulate them with their graduation, and I wish them the best of luck and success in their future career. Now, it's an end to it's an end of learning band to start working, to start their career. I'd like to them to implement all what they have learned during their studies in the college in their future career. They are ready to introduce all technical support to their comrades in the armed forces. I would like to tell all of them to take care of the soldiers, to be fully committed inside the armed forces. As a technical military college, we made the utmost efforts to qualify them for their future. It's time for them to start the real work and to inject new blood into the armed forces. And we're still, well, the graduation ceremony of the armed forces institutions and colleges, we are with Major General Hussein D. Mustafa, the director of the Armed Forces Military Institute, the batch number 50. Congratulations, sir. Tell us, sir, about the qualification and the training of the cadets inside the institute. What are the most important pillars? The General Commander of the Armed Forces all the time directed us to qualify the cadets in the best way ever, and according to the latest techniques and scientific methods. Our cadets are qualified through many pillars to prepare the student, the teaching staff, the educational environment, and the curriculum. The cadets, of course, would continue with his fitness. He already came to me completely fitted, but we develop this via competitions like the Army Leagues. It's one of the most difficult ones of the military performance evaluation. Last year we obtained the third position. The cadet himself is now qualified to learn, and we focus on the practical side. He is the first one to deal with the equipment. The teaching staff, we should have the best teaching staff with the best performance, whether to be qualified with sessions here inside Egypt or with missions abroad. The educational environment should be fit and should be inside well-equipped halls, equipped with internet and with, of course, with remote education also because of COVID-19. The labs are the most modern ones. We are all the time supported with financial support to have labs simulating the equipment. The curricula is developing a day after the other according to the development and modernization of the weaponry, and we do have full coordination with the institution or the authority according to the new weapons we have. And here we do meet with some of the fresher graduates, asking them about their trainings and their qualifications during the 4 years. For example, this is a graduate from the Naval College, and he's speaking about the trainings and the programs he had, whether in theory or practical. From a month to 40 days, there are practical programs on all the equipment, on all the techniques. everything we learned theoretically, we already implemented on the ground. Of course, I'd like also to speak with the parents. How was your reaction when you know that he is going to join a military college? He was very eager to join a military college. He already spent a year in the Faculty of Engineering, but he introduced his papers to join a military college. I encourage him because this was his desire. Now he is graduated, and with the presence of President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, and to the father, what do you say? Of course, I thank God. Thank God. I'm so happy, and of course proud. I feel proud with my son. I congratulate him on the efforts exerted by my son. I already have a bachelor degree in engineering, but I joined also the Naval College. First it was general studies, then I was specialized. The command of the college and the educational branches really care about every single detail, whether the theoretical or the practical ones. And one of the graduates, one of the military institute, now he is honored with having this responsibility to defend the nation. What a noble mission. Kareem Muhammad Ali, a fresh graduate. And today, of course, it's a big day. It's a special day with the attendance of President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, the Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces. I would like to know from you the years of studies, the years inside the institute, the years inside the college. The Naval College has given us everything, whether it's disciplinary, science, physical fitness, the latest techniques and methods in every aspect. And here with another fresh graduate, Naval Lieutenant. Congratulations. How you were qualified during the study, the years of studying? Whether from the theoretical training, the scientific or the engineering materials, and also the trainings inside the modern and latest units, whether via the long hours of sailing and other ways. Tell us about the studies you had in the college or in the academy for 3 years. I entered as a character, and I am out from this academy as another person, completely another person. What are the most important pieces of advice or steps you were given to your son during the studying year? Ziad, thank God, he was all the time a successful student. He already had such high degrees in the last year in the secondary school, and he joined the engineering, the Faculty of Engineering. But when he joined the military academy, he became another person. Now he is 21, but he is such a man. What's the piece of advice you would give to your son starting his career? I'd like him to be more committed, more serious. He is already committed and serious, but I'd like him to show more commitment and more seriousness and sense of belonging and love to the nation, to his comrades, to his teammates, to his, and also the soldiers who are going to work with him, to be a leader or a commander shouldering the responsibility. And we are going to start with the students with how they were treated and how the academy took care of them during the years of studying. of course, physical fitness, disciplinary, the military way of life, moving from the civil way of life to the military way of life. This was a turning point, but there was a social protection. We were taken care of during the whole years of studying. Tell us also more about how you were dealing with the new techniques and how you have learned all the things in the 4 years of studying. There is all the time a kind of modernization or development. We are adopting the latest techniques, all the developments, or modernizing the curricula, and we do have a background of what's going on. And here we are going to go to the impression of the mother, the one who presented her son to be one of the soldiers defending the country. How have you dealt with your son joining a military college? Since day one, he was very committed, and this helped him a lot to achieve success. So commitment was not something strange for him. So he already, and with his sense of accuracy, with his seriousness, he continued to succeed. What's your feeling today? Feeling happy? It's a sense of pride. What? It's a happiness and pride. Since day one, we have this dream to be number one, to achieve the first position, and to take the order of merit from the president. I'm very proud of him.
كنتوا بتركزوا عليه اثناء فتره الاعداد وايه اللي القاده كانوا حريصين انكم تتعرضوا
We'd like to know more about the preparations and how you were qualified as a cadet.
اثناء الاعداد داخل الكليه بيتم اعداد الطالب علميا وبدنيا
We are qualified from all aspects, whether scientifically or physically. We studied the military and engineering subjects.
تنفيذ دور الضحية الألعاب العسكرية زي لعبة الموانع أو الضحية العسكرية أو الخماس العسكري من الناحية الفكرية من خلال عقد ندوات ولقاءات توعية لجميع الطلبة ونفسيا من خلال عقد ندوات ولقاءات أيضا مع أطقم الشؤون النفسية للقوات المسلحة
أنا هسأل الوالد والوالدة يعني النهاردة إيه اللي حضرتك ممكن تكون عايز توجهه رسالة
What the message that you'd like to deliver today in the ceremony of the graduation of your son with the honoring attendance of His Excellency the President of the Arab Republic of Egypt I'm really thankful that Almighty God has enabled my son to have such accomplishment and I was having such faith that he will have such accomplished such status and I'm so glad to have such promise accomplished by the Almighty God who has held my son to be a combat officer to defend Egypt. Well, tell me about the years of your studies. What was the kind of qualifications, building capacities, whether theoretical or practical, what exactly that you were listening to from your leaders? Well, actually, through the 5 years of the military college, I was highly qualified throughout the exercises, education, and lots of curriculum that by which we can be parallel to all of the other counterpart curriculum in the world with very prominent leaders, whether on the civilian or military levels. I've also got a very good time where I can exercise sports and tactics, and we've got a lot of facilitation to such conduction throughout our yards where we've been able to build our capacities, and I've now got the excellent record first ranking first on the batch, so congratulations. And now you will have this ceremony for the graduation with the attendance of the chief commander of the armed forces and His Excellency the President of the State. So what exactly you'd like to say today in that regards? I congratulate him that he made me feel in such proud and happiness, and encourage all the families to motivate their sons to be just like our sons. So the day that he submitted to the military college of the armed forces, throughout these years, what you found that it was really changed in his personality? Well, actually, I found that he's been completely changed. He's become so accountable, responsible. I see him that along with your colleagues now at the graduation ceremony that will be attended by His Excellency the President of the Arab Republic of Egypt. What does this symbolize? It's a great honor and pride that His Excellency will be with us to have him among us in our celebration. So we thank him. Thank you so much and congratulations. Congratulations to all of you. This was our meeting with the Lieutenant Sharif Adil, one of the top cadets of the Armed College in the ceremony of the Armed Forces for today.
شرف كتفان سنة كمان سلع.
احييكم مشاهدينا الكرام.
Dear viewers, from the numerous arenas of our great college of military that we've witnessing the graduation of new batches, we're supplying Egypt with the best of the soldiers of the Egyptian Armed Forces. And today we celebrate the graduation of a new batch from the military of Armed Forces number 115. Under the name of Abdel Nabi Khaber, the previous chief commander, in addition to other numerous military and military technical college graduations. Dear viewers, having new blood in the veins of the Egyptian Armed Forces play a great role in defending the nations and to defend its assets and lands and to be a shield and a solid defense against any who would think that they can intervene. And this ceremony will be honored with the attendance of His Excellency, the President of the Arab Republic of Egypt, the Chief Commander of the Armed Forces, in addition to the Lieutenant General Mohammed Zaki, the Minister of Defense and Military Production, and First Lieutenant Mahmoud Farid, the Chief Commander of the Armed Forces, in addition to another number of the prominent and budget Armed Forces officers, in addition to another number of the ministers who all come together to attend this ceremony, along with another number of Egyptian men who will participate in this celebration to commemorate the graduation of the new batch of the Armed College, Military College, and the Military Technical College. Dear viewers, all of the Military Technical Institution and the Military Colleges that we have for the graduation of new batches from the Armed Forces soldiers who will formulate this strong shield to defend this nation and its destiny. So here we come together to celebrate the graduation of the best of the patriots who will play just like their ancestors in October at 1973, in October War, that we usually commemorate, and this year was its 48th anniversary. And His Excellency, the President of the Arab Republic of Egypt, has conducted in October, in celebration of this war anniversary, on the importance of gathering together and to have this cohesion among others, and to have the great understanding and this awareness that can play its significant role, that can in turn preserve this country. This wise understanding that can help all of those efforts and endeavors that are exerted, and the state gives all it takes through all of the bodies and institutions collaborating together to defend and to provide this. So for instance, in the commemoration of Prophet Muhammad's birth date, there was a speech by His Excellency the Minister of Endowment, and His Excellency the great Imam, and also the President has talked about the understanding and the conception that can help in this framework by the collaboration and the cohesion of the whole targeted bodies to filter the understandings and to alter these misconceptions and to moderate the religious speeches to be more effective and more identical to reality on the ground without having any intervene into the authentic religious. So dear viewers, today we celebrate the bombing of new blood into the venous of our armed forces officers with the graduation of our military college today, and also just a few days ago we were celebrating the graduation of the new batches of the police academy, who also play their great role along with the patriot armed forces soldiers. soldiers defending our lands. So here we have everyone just code for the defense of the nation, for defending the concept of the patriotism, the transparent patriotism, the devotion to the nations, which is deeply constructed in all of our souls. And this is very important and clearly stated in such a transition period that we have, especially with the different types of the wars. Now the wars have been transformed from just traditional to have these new wars where we use all tools and approaches that are not traditional any longer. And such require to have also response that can match these approaches. And this is one of the challenges that's been imposed on our lands. And this also has its own repercussions and reflections. So if we will talk, for instance, about the military college, there is a professional and upgrading on the educational levels. There's a great concern paid to the numerous generations graduated from. Now we've got His Excellency the Chief Commander, the Minister of Defense and Military Production.
السيد القائد العام للقوات المسلحة.
Commander in chief of the armed forces, the minister of defense and military production. Honoring guards, attention guards to His Excellency, the Commander Chief.
حرس الشرف.
Honoring guards. Good morning, everyone, and many happy returns of the day.
From inside this great bacon, we've got training of the soil patriots on the basics of
the military life, which is patriotism, nation, and this has helped them to defend the country throughout the whole years. And on the margin of the celebration, the batch of October 2021, we will now have the understanding of the construction of this college. We welcome you in the Museum of the Armed Forces that have the very ancient days from the Pharaonic days of the Armed Forces till these days. Well, this has been started in Muhammad Ali era, where we constructed the first military school in the citadel in 1811. Afterwards, it's been moved to Aswan. The military school moved to Aswan in 1821, and we got Suleiman Basha assigned as the principal of the school. He was the first military principal. Well, could you please tell us the locations where the military school has been moved to? It has been moved to numerous locations, starting from the Khedewi Saeed era. It was moved to Konatel. Afterwards, it's been moved to Abbasiyah in Ismail Basha era, and in Abbas the second era, it's been moved to Kobri al-Oba. We want to know when this been changed from the name of military school to military college. This will take us to King Farouk era. In King Farouk era, on the 14th of March 1938, there was a decree to change the name of the military school to be the Military Royal School. And on the 3rd of March 1955, we got the inauguration of Abdel Nasser Military College, which is the current location in New Cairo. Could you please tell us the explanation of the upgrade of the slogans of the military schools till we got to the military academy? Yes, it's been developed since the 1911 in Muhammad Ali Basha era. And then in 1933, where we changed the name of the military school to be military college. Afterwards, in 1958, in the unification between Egypt and Syria. Afterwards, in 1985, with the change of the flag, and we got the change of the slogan, which is the one that we have till now. The Military Academy Museum is a great place, and it's a place of pride where we got to know the change from military school to military academy, and also got to know the history from the Farah history. Now we will get to the main podium for the receiver of His Excellency, the President of the Arab Republic of Egypt, the Chief Commander of the Armed Forces. New generations get emerging every year for defending the destiny of the nations and the soil of the lands, defending the homeland from whoever would think of trespassing these lands. New generations join one of the greatest and strongest armies, the Egyptian army. They join the crews of our armed forces officers today with the generation, with the graduation of the new batch, the 115 batch of Abdurrab al-Nabi Hafiz, the previous chief of the armed of the military college, in addition to the graduation of other cadets from the military technical college and military institutions. Those are the best Egyptian men and youth, those who have the significant role to defend the land, to work defending its territories along with their colleagues and brothers from the civilian police cadets, where they have strong relations, where they have in such a framework their patriotism, their devotion to their country, and to be working on upgrading the dignity of this nation, and to be usually on top of the nations as we seen and we've seen throughout the decades and centuries. And in that framework today, and within the framework of the celebrations of the 48th anniversary of war of October, work that's been achieved not just by the armed forces but also by the backbone, who was the Egyptian people, where no one could differentiate between citizens and officers. All were just one hand defending the lands, defending this home nation that we are all devoted to. And this is crystal clear stated by the martyrdom represented by the Egyptian people and officers against this violent aggression in October 73, where they have managed to get this victory against this violence, and our armed forces, along with the civilian police officers, have been able to eliminate these terrorism spots and also to eliminate the infrastructure of these terrorism. So the Egyptian police, the Egyptian understanding, the Egyptian armed forces have all gathered to play along together in that framework, by which the Egyptian people, with their understanding and their awareness for the importance of what we live, to be the backbone and to be just standing alongside with their soldiers and officers from police and from armed forces, to enhance them combating these rumors that used to get spread in the air. However, no one could be able to penetrate the understanding and the principles of the Egyptian and also of our armed forces, since they're raising time inside their homes and in their schools. This devotion that they've been raised up to, and this patriotism, and to have the nation on top of their priorities, these are the principles where the generations have been raised up to, and that can drive them all in the future to be a strong shield, to defend with all what they have, and to defend the nation and the land. So best of girls, best of females and males, those graduates of the military academies who will play the same backbone role for the nationwide. So now we are waiting for the arrival of His Excellency, the President of the Arab Republic of Egypt, the Commander in Chief, Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, to celebrate with his sons of the cadets of the military technical college and military institution graduations. In such ceremony, which is very important, reflects the great devotion of those cadets to their nation despite all of the challenges. So all of those joined the military technical college and the military institutions, those youth who have joined the colleges in such critical area where we got increase of those rumors and these strong challenges, but again they were able to join these colleges, and we will see the tangible result today by their graduation to be an officer, a defender for the land, for the values, the principles, as the fundamental principles that they've been raised up to. Maybe those are the principles that those cadets have been believing in, this combating
في نفوس
deeply settled in those cadets who have been raised up on the Egyptian military life by joining these military colleges and institutions. Hence, now in simultaneous framework with the collaboration with the commemoration of the October victory, along with the graduation of our cadets from the military technical colleges and the military institutions, all together in celebration of the victorious war where Egyptians have Now let's move to the main podium, His Excellency the President of the Republic of Egypt, Abdel Fattah Sisi, the Chief in Command of the Armed Forces.
السيد الرئيس عبد الفتاح السيسي رئيس الجمهورية القائد الأعلى للقوات
The commander in chief of the armed forces. Honoring guards, the national anthem. Attention, guards.
حرس الشرف كتفان سلاح الدوران للخارج للخارج دور
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
Allah, the most merciful, the most compassionate.
من مصنع الرجال
from the factory of men, the arena of patriots, from the military college, with the celebration of Egypt for the anniversary of October 73 that has regained to the nation its pride and dignity. So the Egyptian armed forces celebrate today with the graduation of new batches for the soldiers and the cadets of the Military Technical College and the military institutions. Those youth full of faith and enthusiasm along with willingness will join today one of the greatest and the biggest Egyptian army. The Egyptian army that will be honored with the attendance of His Excellency, the President of the Arab Republic of Egypt, the Commander and Chief of the Armed Forces, Abdel Fattah Sisi. And on the sky of the parade, you see the paratroopers having the Egyptian flags flying in the sky, along with the Armed Forces flag and along with the sub-branches of the Armed Forces flags. And in the heaven of the parade and in the front scene, we will have the formulation of the paratroops of Grob Air Forces, formulating the number of 48 as commemoration for the October historical anniversary and for marking the commencement of the celebration. Now we will commence our celebration today with the sport and combating and the defending skills, self-defense skills on the yard. Now we have more than 1,000 combat cadets from the Military Technical College and military institutions of the Armed Forces. They are just like flooding into the floor, showing their tactics and their capabilities and their capacities and their daily exercises. They are pushing very strongly in front of the podium. A number of the cadets carrying some of the military devices to conduct some of the numerous exercises along with another group presenting their skills and their special self skills. In front of the podium, we have a number of the group providing a number of the self-athletic skills, along with another group providing also the exercises where they are trained inside the matrix, presenting their great bodybuilding skills that they have. Trilateral exercises where the combat cadets perform to upscale their bodybuilding skills. And now the cadets are performing some of the exercises of the bilateral exercises to upgrade the teamwork spirit and collaboration skills. Some glimpse of the flexibility that provide the great trainings they were undertaking. Now, cadets will move to conduct a number of the exercises of the quartet, exercises that present the quality of the combat cadets in providing these exercises. And from the great concern of the military to provide the perfect environment for the perfect bodybuilding, so the armed forces have got this year ISO 22. 1001 for the food chain that also had got the military academy to get the bodybuilding shield for the military technical college and the military institutions of the armed forces. Strength. Wellness, believing, and victory. The cadets have now presented the numbers of the batches of the technical college and military institutions graduations. Long live Egypt, pride and dignity always on the lands. Cadets singing the national anthem on the floor. Now we see on both sides of the parade the combatant cadets with their bicycles presenting their skills and getting unified in driving the bicycles, which helps in upskilling their body skills and bodybuilding skills. Now the cadets are performing inside the celebration parade, very organized formulation, they're presenting their self-confidence and the great qualifications. It's worth of saying that the riding bicycles is being a new training added to the military academies because it helps in upskilling the cadets and strengthen all of their muscles and to reviving their blood cycle. Now we have the skills of those bike riders in the organizing of the numerous formulation inside the parade land. Such a performance that shows the great skills and capacities they have. The distinguished attendees, we want to notify you that we will use the audio speakers. Now you can see all of the cadets presenting their combating skills and the self-defense skills just right in front on both sides of the skills. You have two from the commanders providing numerous skills, and also on both sides you have the cadets of the military and police academies in collaboration with the commanders from the special forces and the paratroopers in the quick descending activities. And right in front of the podium, you have a number of the cadets to combat in and presenting their tactics, numerous freestyle tactics and in life of the armed forces, of the importance of motivating the top athletes to be on top of the sports events. Now we have the Egyptian athletes who got the Paralympic and the Olympic medals in Tokyo 2020, along with the Egyptian Armed Forces, Colonel Mohammed Abdu Abusteit, who has gained and came first in the World Kickboxing Competition Air Force One. Right in front of the parade, you have a number of the combat cadets performing some of those freestyle tactics. Those are the future defenders, the chain of the patriots, the best men, the self and weapon when it comes to need, those builders of the defense with their willing and belief in Allah, just very strong like those mountains. May Allah bless you. With you, we can achieve our dreams. Now with the presentation of the Armed Forces equipment. In framework of the general leadership of the Armed Forces for having the graduation of the cadets who can organize their own equipment. Now we have some of the weapons and equipment that the military technical colleges and institutions are trained inside their very specialized educational pavilions. The March Pavilion with their slogan Strength, Wellness, Victory. YBR vehicle, and now in the heaven of the parade, number of the fourth generation and the advanced fourth generation paratroopers. Now, right in front of the podium and with the quick march, the military men presenting their upscaling skills they have trained up to. And now with the armored and the defense pavilions, these great weapons against our enemies. Now in the parade heaven and right in front of the podium, we have formulation of the attacking numerous types helicopter. Now the supplying authority. The Marine Corps. The Air Aviation Corps providing defense for all of the armored units, the 2M2 missile unit, the Book M2 Middle Autonomous and with the Special Commanders, this armored Sherpa vehicle followed by the terrorism combatant Mercedes and the combatant Alford F-550. The paratroopers, the thunder from the sky just in front of the podium, having this vehicle followed by the flying along with other vehicles combined with the freestyle jumping and ATV equipment, another vehicle having this practical model for the heavy descending equipment. It's worth mentioning that the first sky jumping in Egypt sky was in 1952 with the dawn of history, where the Egyptian ancient people were excellent in the usage of the musical instruments in wars to motivate their soldiers and to celebrate their victories. Now with the military musical parade, now we have the military musicians for the first time, along with 1,200 musicians from males and females to present their skills in front of you and to continue what their ancient ancestors have been excellent in. My country, the history and the security, and this is strong factory for men, stand for all countries with their solution, and we are devoted defending with this great heart. We overcome all the impossible and we are the shields. We are the eagles defending the homeland, and we can pay our souls defending with this great heart. We've overcome what's impossible, and we are the shields, weapons, and eagles defending its land. Generations of patriots. Generations of patriots, factory of the armed forces who believe that the best word in the world is long live Egypt. Discipline and excellence in this engineering panel expressing the great level of trainings they have undertaken. The best nation's armies are ours. And hardships come and see how we can defeat, and nothing can stop us. The best armies in the world is ours. And hardships come and see how we defeat. Once we see our enemies, nothing could stop us from attacking. The slogan of the armed forces being formulated by the military musicians on a very professional level. Long live our generations, long live defending the homeland, just one principle, one man, long live for our generations. Who's ever been devoted to you can teach generation after generation Egypt that you taught us to remove from dictionaries the word of impossible. Who's ever been devoted to your love can teach generation after generation Egypt that taught us that we can remove from dictionaries the word of impossible. Our beloved country, Egypt. Egypt. Long live Egypt. For our generations to tell everyone inside Egypt, my beloved country, Egypt. Egypt, long live. And now we have in front of you the jazz band that will play ultimate musical notes. Our pride, our dignity, Egypt, our mother country, our pride and dignity, source of life, gift of the Lord, the great people and strong army. The great people and a strong army. And now, along with the musical instruments, the solo with the military musicians, a group of musicians playing a number of military songs in celebration of October victory anniversary. In the name of Lord, Allah the greatest, in the name of Lord, in the name of Lord, call for pray and say Allah the greatest. We're going, carrying our weapon, and we're returning back, lifting the flags of pride, and we're taking oaths with the commitment of Allah to give our souls for our lands. Long live my home country. Long live my home country. Long live my homeland with their green crops. Long live my homeland with your flag is up in the air. Long live with your name in the universe. Long live with your equipment operating in the long way. Long live my home country. My eyes are not sleep. We will get back to the best days. Egypt, the mother country of the world, for which I love the world. I got no second sleeping or awake without you in front of my eyes. Oh, my eyes do not sleep. We will get back to our best days. My beloved country, the greatest of all, day after day, with the victories are achieved. Those victories and achievements are filling the air of the environment in the country, just moving forward. All Arabs are my brothers. We combat struggle with the one unified role. All Arab are my brothers, my blood pride, and they are my brotherly countries. Our defense is unified by a single prophet. All Arabs are my brothers.
عرض المهارات الفنية باستخدام السلاح.
The weapon skills presentation.
وسنستعرض أمام
And now we will show the greatest levels of trainings on the usage of weapons that need to have a great nerve and muscle skills.
قوة الردع.
Defending corps.
قوي صحيح.
Army is one of the greatest armies in the region. But it is a wise army. An army that defends, not threatens. An army that secure and not aggress. These are our fundamental beliefs that knows no change.
يحق لك يا مصر أن تفخري
Egypt, you have the right to feel pride with those lines, defenders of your lands and skies, the best of the soldiers of the Lord on land, defenders of the lands and seas. They have just one goal, which is victory. Bless you, the Nile defenders, the backbone of the generation. With you, Egypt will long live.
ويبقى الانضباط العسكري
discipline and the military discipline is the fundamental characteristic of our old armed forces and it's one approach to control these high qualified combatant trainings and as we can see in the military parade
هنا الكنانة
Here we have the land, stand still, O history, witness with the past and the present. Here we have the civilizations, long constructed pyramids, where skies are saluting, and Allah, the Lord, committed to defend its sources. So countries will never lose, will never be lost, that are defended by Allah the Almighty. The Egyptian army, with all of support received, you have the angels defending. You have not thrown, but it's the hands of Allah. So your arrows will never mislead their destiny. And now on the musician, on the music of the war drums, and we have the leader of the drummers, and we have the flags, on top of which is the armed forces flag, the symbol of pride and dignity. And now we have the flow of the military groups for the military technical colleges graduates and the military institutions graduates and police academy graduates.
كمان يا فندم عميد أركان الحرب محمد سمير زغاري.
محمد سمير زغاري the leader of the coup.
تفضل يا فندم.
Yes please go ahead. The military forces are ready to move with the march, 20 steps between groups and backward turn. Straight march.
على يسار المنصة قائد طابور العرب العسكري
the military crew
left-hand
flags headed by the armed forces flag symbol of our dignity and pride. Afterwards, the military institutions and the military technical colleges flags along with the police academy flags and other flags of the various pavilions. Long live Egypt, the dearest country. May all your flags are flying in the sky. Headed on top of the queue with the words of Farouk Gweda and rhythm of Kamal Tawil. And now in front of the podium, we have the first group of the Military Academy graduates. The group of the police academy, those who just spend their night defending Egypt, witnessing their ceremony today with this image reflecting their relationship that sends peace, hope and security inside the souls of the Egyptians. And now with the air graduates. Now the group of the air graduates, air corps graduates. And then the group of the military college graduates.
And
now group of the Navy graduates.
مجموعة خريج الكلية الفنية العسكرية.
The technical military, the military technical college graduates.
مجموعة خريج كلية الطب.
Now the group of the medicine armed forces college.
مجموعة خريج المعهد الفني للقوات المسلحة.
The Military Technical College graduates.
Thank you.
شعب مصر الأبي.
Egypt, people, now you can see inside the line of the armed forces, you have those soldiers who have been trained to move each to their arena, defending their lands, seeding their seeds into the history. The history books, and they know well the value of joining the mother country of the world, Egypt. Egypt, the meaningful paradise even before the starting of the universe, where beforehand no other country has been known, where the messages of Almighty Lord been revealed. This fragrance of Maria, the historical achievement in the history, paving their ways, and Maryam has paved the ways with the best soldiers of the land. Allah the Lord grant you victory if you will devote to Allah. Now we have the souls of our martyrs just surrounding our arena. Military groups, attention to our martyrs. Military groups, shoulder weapons. The head of the training unit of the armed forces to announce the graduation. In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most compassionate. His Excellency, the Chief Commander, the Minister of Defense and Military Production, has endorsed the results of the military academies and the Military Technical College as first, as coming. The 115 Armored Batch and the 114 Military Colleges with the high Bachelor of Science. Secondly, the first batch of the master degrees, the certification of conduction of military education. Thirdly, batch 72 from the Navy Forces to have the Navy BA. Fourth, 88 Air Troopers batch and Air Military Science to have Air BS degree. Fifth, to grant the batch 58 from the Military Technical College to have Engineering BA with the Conduction Certificate. Sixth, 49 batch of Air Troopers to have the degree of BA of Air Military Science. Seventh, to grant the third batch of the Armed Forces College of Medicine the degree of Surgery and Medicine BS with the Conduction of Military Education Certificate. Eighth, 50 batch of technical institution to have the certificate of the Armed Forces Technical Institution. The percentage of those who have been approved for the conduction of the certificate, 100%. The military groups, shoulder weapons. Delivering and hand over the leadership. I commit to preserve the values of my academy inside and outside. Commandant, the commands of my leaders believe in the slogan of my academy. So here we hand over, we got the handover of the leadership for the new generations by the graduate generations. And here we got the flags of the military academies and the military technical college flags along with their new leaders.
جمع الخريجين.
The group of graduates.
هيظهر الآن في سماء العرض فريق الألعاب الجوية النجوم الفضية
مدير إدارة شؤون ضباط القوات المسلحة. The head of the affairs of graduates to assign the assigning of the graduates and given the merits to the top cadets. In the name of Allah, His Excellency the President of the State, the Chief Commander of the Armed Forces has endorsed the common first to assign the graduates of 115 military armed forces, 72 navy, 88 air aviation, 49 air defense, and 114 armed forces and 50 batch for military technical college to be assigned to first lieutenant under and also the combat officers for the entitled for under lieutenant and for the sub cadets for the first lieutenant and colonel according to their scientific degrees starting from 30th of June 2021. Secondly, assigning the graduates of the third batch of the College of Medicine of Armed Forces for the first lieutenant starting from 1st of October 2021. Thirdly, the top cadets to have the military second ranking merits, acknowledging for their commitments with their discipline during education by the military medicine. Farouk Reda Farouk, lieutenant under test. Lieutenant under test Islam Nader Zaghloul. First Lieutenant under test Ahmad Radwan Muhammad. Colonel Physician Fadwa Muhammad Hamad. From Guinea under test First Lieutenant Ahmed Layan. From Palestine Lieutenant under test Muhammad Salim Khalid. From Somali, under test First Lieutenant Muawiyah Uthman. From Navy Academy, under test Lieutenant Ahmed Ibrahim Qadi Dawla. From Kuwait, under test First Lieutenant Amir Ganoub Al-Amir. From Yemen, Navy Lieutenant under test Ayman Abdullah Salem. From Air Force Academy under test First Lieutenant Saifuddin Hassan Abdul Salam. Under test First Lieutenant Abdullah Ashraf Muhammad. From Sudan Pilot Lieutenant under test Muhammad Hassan Bashir. From Military Technical College, First Lieutenant under test Muhammad Said Mustafa. From Bahrain, First Lieutenant under test Muhammad Mahmoud Hassan. From Air Aviation Forces, First under Lieutenant Said Diva Ali. And from KSA, First Lieutenant under test Mish'al bin Saad bin Sulaiman. From College of Medicine of Armed Forces under test First Lieutenant Physician Ahmed Abdul Hamid Fathi. From the Technical Institution First Lieutenant under test Magdi Muhammad Abu Farah. From the background of the great leaders, we got the names on the batches of the graduation this year in commemoration for the patriotism they have presented. Now we will play a documentary movie presented by the Moral Affairs Department entitled With Leaders in the Heart of the Nation.
وسجلات التاريخ وفي تلك السجلات تسطع رموز عسكرية مضيئة استحقت أن يخلد ذكراها في التاريخ وأن يسجل أسماؤها بحروف من نور في سجلات الشرف العسكرية المصرية. ومن هؤلاء الرجال الفريق محمد علي محمد أمين قائد القوات البحرية الأسبق التحق بالكلية البحرية وتخرج فيها في الأول من يناير عام 1950. شارك في حروب مصر المعاصرة وكان له دور كبير في عملية الإعداد والتخطيط للقوات البحرية أثناء حرب الاستنزاف وحرب أكتوبر عام 73. تدرج بالوظائف المختلفة بالقوات البحرية حتى تولى منصب قائد القوات البحرية في 9 من أكتوبر عام 1978 وحتى عام 1983 وتقديرا لدوره وتاريخه في العسكرية المصرية أطلق اسمه على الدفعة 72 بحرية. اللواء طيار محمد نبيه المسيري رئيس أركان القوات الجوية الأسبق التحق بالكلية الحربية وتخرج فيها في 9 فبراير عام 1950، ثم التحق بالكلية الجوية ليتخرج فيها في 1 يوليو عام 1951. تدرج في المناصب القيادية بالقوات الجوية حتى وصل إلى منصب رئيس أركان القوات الجوية في الفترة من 24 إبريل عام 1972 وحتى 30 يونيو 1979. وتقديرا لدوره وتاريخه في العسكرية المصرية أطلق اسمه على الدفعة 88 جوية. اللواء أركان حرب أحمد سلامة غنيم رئيس شعبة عمليات الدفاع الجوي الأسبق التحق بالكلية الحربية وتخرج فيها في سبتمبر عام 1940 وتدرج في المناصب القيادية حتى وصل إلى رئيس شعبة عمليات الدفاع الجوي، حيث شارك في الإعداد والتجهيز والتنفيذ لحرب أكتوبر المجيدة. وتقديرا لدوره العظيم في العسكرية المصرية استحق أن يطلق اسمه على الدفعة 49 دفاع جوي. اللواء دكتور عبد الحميد شوقي عبد اللطيف الشريف مدير الكلية الفنية العسكرية الأسبق. تدرج اللواء دكتور عبد الحميد شوقي في الوظائف المختلفة بالقوات المسلحة حتى عين مديرا للكلية الفنية العسكرية في الفترة من عام 1975 وحتى عام 1979. وعبر مسيرة طويلة من العمل الجاد كان له دور كبير في تطوير منظومة الصواريخ استعدادا ليوم الكرامة، واستحق أن تكرمه العسكرية المصرية بإطلاق اسمه على الدفعة 58 فنية عسكرية. اللواء بحري حسن حسين عزو مدير المعهد الفني للقوات المسلحة الأسبق التحق بالقوات المسلحة ضمن الدفعة 3 مهندسين عسكريين. تدرج في المناصب القيادية داخل القوات المسلحة حتى تولى منصب مدير المعهد الفني للقوات المسلحة. وتقديرا لمسيرة عطائه في القوات المسلحة استحق أن تخلد ذكراه ويطلق اسمه على الدفعة 50 معهد فني. اللواء طبيب محمد عبد الوهاب عبد المنعم محمد مدير إدارة الخدمات الطبية الأسبق التحق بالكلية الحربية ضمن الدفعة 7 أطباء. وتدرج في المناصب القيادية حتى تولى رئاسة المجلس الطبي العسكري العام، ثم رئيس أركان إدارة الخدمات الطبية، ثم مديرا لها. وتقديرا لعطائه أطلق اسمه على الدفعة 3 كلية الطب بالقوات المسلحة. وتسطع الأسماء المضيئة في سجلات العسكرية المصرية، فيتجلى اسم الفريق عبد رب النبي حافظ رئيس أركان حرب القوات المسلحة الأسبق. ولد الفريق عبد رب النبي حافظ في 16 يوليو عام 1930، وتخرج في الكلية الحربية في 1 فبراير عام 1949. تمر السنوات ويتولى الفريق عبد رب النبي حافظ قيادة الفرقة 16 مشاة، ويصدر القرار بالاقتحام المدبر لأصعب مانع مائي، ويخوض رجال الفرقة 16 مشاة ضمن فرق المشاة 5 ملاحم قتالية ضارية شرق قناة السويس، محققين نصرا عسكريا مبينا. وتنتهي الحرب ولا ينتهي العطاء، ويعين اللواء عبد رب النبي حافظ في منصب أمين عام وزارة الدفاع، ثم رئيسا لأركان الجيش الثاني الميداني فقائدا له، ويتولى بعد ذلك رئاسة هيئة عمليات القوات المسلحة، ليعين بعد ذلك رئيسا لأركان حرب القوات المسلحة في إبريل عام 1981. وكان حقا على القوات المسلحة المصرية أن تطلق اسم الفريق عبد رب النبي حافظ على الدفعة 115 حربية. تتوالى العصور وتمر السنوات وتتعاقب الأجيال في حمل الرايات، ولا تنسى الأمة المصرية رموزها المضيئة من أبناء العسكرية المصرية ديلا بعد ديل.
مجموعات العرض العسكري كتفا سلاح
Attention.
يمين الولاء
The oath.
اقسم بالله العظيم اقسم بالله العظيم
I commit tenfold by Allah the Lord
أن أكون جندياً وفياً لجمهورية مصر العربية.
to be a loyal soldier to the Arab Republic of Egypt, preserving its security and settlement, defending and protecting its lands on land, in sea and air, inside and outside the Republic, obeying the commands of my military leaders, executing my leaders' commands, maintaining my weapon, never leave my weapon till I lose my soul. And Allah is witnessing my oath.
فريق الألعاب الجوية ينفذون مناورة الوردة المتفتحة
now play the opening flower in the sky of the parade.
مجموعات الأرض العسكري.
Military groups, attention, guards. The speech, as you can see, Dr. Ashraf Salem Zahir, the president of the military academy. In the name of Almighty Lord, Your Excellency, the President Abdel Fattah Sisi, the President of the Arab Republic of Egypt, the Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces, the distinguished attendees, with the great pride and the best appreciation words, I am honored to welcome you inside my national citadel, the military army and the military college that has made nation and pride and dignity as its slogan. Now, with our great history that's being colored with the victorious records, supplying the nation with the best men, with elite youth, our distinguished attendees, for the great ceremony that we witness every year, where we see our sons with their strong bodies and qualifications to take their first steps towards defending the achievements and assets of our nation. Those are the sons of Egypt and the spirit of hopes. And this comes alongside with the Egyptian ceremony, along with the armed forces, for the 48th anniversary of the October 73 anniversary. So our today's graduates, they are visualizing the generation of October as their role models, from whom they breathe in the fragrance of their victories. So appreciation and salutation to October generation, who has regained to our land its pride and dignity. Your Excellency, the Chief Commander of the Armed Forces, the responsibility of getting our combat officers in such level, it's not easy, especially if they will take the lead of the lines, defending their nation, that look forward to what they will do to preserve its security and nation's safety. And we here inside the military academy, along with all of the other military academies and institutions, understand fully the value of these duties from the first minute where we got our sons joining our academy. We start to work on building their capacities and their personifications, and to alter that in a way that can be identical to the principles of our military fundamentals, where we develop their devotion and loyalty. So we have our sons of today to be our future soldiers. Emerging from this point, we have upgraded our curriculum to upscale the educational approach in a way which is the identical to the current time and according to your guidelines, with the importance of having our combat officers from those educational qualified cadets. We have opened our doors for the students with higher educational degrees to join our lines, and now we have the graduation of these batches. And as long as we also pay concern to the building capacity of our combat officers, we also work on formulating their mindsets against any of those non-traditional wars that are targeting the nations, and because we do believe in the importance of having the collaboration between both sides of security. So the common exercises between the cadets of the military academy and the police academy together are working in parallel to leverage implementing the common missions so we can have security and safety spreading in the country. Your Excellency, this national institution has always been paying gratitude to those who deserve. So allow me, Excellency, to pay tribute and appreciation to our great elite leaders, the principals of the military colleges and academies, the previous principals, for what they have exerted and provided and what they have achieved, which is a result of what they have taken in the first stance. Also, we would like to pay special tribute to my colleagues, the heads of the military colleges and academies, along with the staff, for all of the endeavors exerted while preparing this generation of the cadets. So the responsibility of providing those sons to the nation is a great pride, which has no other thing to compare to. My dear graduates, I recommend all of you to leverage everything that you learned from. Put Egypt at your top priority and make from this oath that you just took to be your own approach and discipline. Never get away from it. Preserve your weapons and do good to your soldiers. Those are the best soldiers of the universe. And to our families of the future soldiers, I pay you great congratulations for everything that you paid towards raising up your sons till they have joined the lines of the Egyptian armed forces. And in conclusion, we promise you, Your Excellency, that we will continue committed to our promise, and we will just spare no efforts with our elite soldiers who will raise the flags of defense for Egypt to be long live with pride and strength. May Allah preserve our soldiers from any bad destinies, and peace be on all of you. Your Excellency, the President of the Arab Republic of its State, the Chief of Command, allow me, Your Excellency, to provide the Quran to Your Excellency to preserve you and the nation. The top graduates of the military institutions, the police academy, and the military academy, providing memorial present to His Excellency, the President of the Arab State, the Commander-in-Chief. Your Excellency, the President, your sons, the graduates of the military academies and institutions, have just taken their vows and oaths, and now we're taking responsibility of defending the lands with our blood and souls. And my colleagues has urged me to send you a message that we promise you that we will be the corner and the weapon and the shield that can protect the nation from all those conspirators of the enemies and whoever would like and whoever would think to intervene into the assets of Egypt. And occasionally it's our pride and happiness to provide Your Excellency the shield of the military institutions, expressing our commitment, and that will be the backbone to your great guidelines. So please. And now with the top graduates of the military technical college and the military institutions also join their colleagues and they congratulate them. Your Excellency, we are the top graduates of the Egyptian universities. Here we come from the various provinces of Egypt with our will and strong belief, putting our hands together along with our cadets and graduates of the military institutions and academies, along with the police academy. And we take an oath that we will exert all of our energies and activities to make sure that Egypt will always be as we used to see, just like you, like what we see under your guidelines. And we all have agreed to be just one line shielding, hand in hand, pushing this development ship and vessel and protecting against any enemies. Your Excellency, we are proud that we are under this citadel, the factory of men from the military academy, to present Your Excellency the shield of the Egyptian universities as a symbol of our trust in your guidance and our devotion to our mother country. And we're asking Allah the Almighty to protect Your Excellency and to maintain the destiny of Egypt and its people. So we will keep saying and our heads up in the sky, long live Egypt, long live Egypt, long live Egypt. So here you go, to Your Excellency. Military parade groups. Mohammed, just give me a minute to congratulate people and to also congratulate the families of our sons. So please make another attention guard. Right, so in the name of Allah, the Most Merciful, the Most Compassionate, praising to Almighty God, congratulations to all the families and congratulations to all of our graduates, our new officers, and my warm congratulations to all families and warm congratulations to each family presented and still presenting for the security, settlement, and safety of Egypt. We are usually concerned with the fact that within such good times where we will never forget our casualties and martyrs who have provided and are still providing till this moment and their souls. And again, this is something that we used to see. So this mission that's been assigned by the police and military soldiers, which is protecting Egypt. So I pay tribute to all of the families of the martyrs. And as I say, I congratulate the families. So congratulations and best wishes that after a long time of raising up from your side to your sons and girls, and then within the educational time inside the colleges and all of these efforts. But again, this is a new stage. I say this to the new officers. You are liable and you will be responsible to your colleagues and for sure responsible of yourselves. And this is a great mission and a great responsibility that you are liable to prepare and to raise awareness. And for sure, yes, raising awareness, because you might will have one of our sons join the army for a year, two, or even three. Subsequently, we are liable in front of Allah and in front of the Egyptian people to make sure that they are well prepared and that they are well equipped for the mission they are assigned to. This is a very valuable mission to prepare a human caliber. Otherwise, you will put him in risk. And then comes the raising awareness. So for you to raise up awareness of others, it requires that you should be fully aware in the first hand. And I'm not saying to be alert for everything. You should be alert with everything surrounding you to increase your readings, to also be able to fulfill your role, and as I said, with all of your colleagues on all levels. This is very important to be taken into consideration, and as the principal of the academy just stated, that the fourth and the fifth generation wars, they all rely on wars, not by using weapons, but it's the weapons of understanding, away from illiteracy and the false awareness. So this is why I again highlight that you are getting into a new stage. We have done everything from our side towards all of our graduates, from males and females. But again, you should continue this march of preparation and self-management and self capabilities, along with the military and police academies that they provide to their sons. So again, I congratulate all of the families, and I want to say thank you. May Allah protect your sons, protect our sons, protect the military and police academies and our nations. Thank you so much. Military parade groups, attention.
As-salam al-watani.
The national anthem.
Salam. Sirah.
Attention, guards.
Tahya Jumhuriyat Masr al-Arabiya.
Long live Arab Republic of Egypt.
Tahya Jumhuriyat Masr al-Arabiya.
Long live Arab Republic of Egypt.
تحيا جمهورية مصر
العربية. Long live Arab Republic of Egypt.
Cut for!